The Honourable Mulder.
Speaker, Mr. Kathrada was a member of the first parliament after 1994. I am one of the few members left in this fifth parliament that served with Mr. Kathrada in that first parliament. We are only about 12 members left in this parliament that also served in 1994 parliament. On many points, I differed from Mr. Kathrada, but we also had many points in common. He was born in the small northwest town of Schweizerenica, and I lived in Schweizerenica for several years. We often shared our memories of Schweizerenica. We also shared an attitude of searching for win-win solutions that accommodate everyone in South Africa, therefore leading to positive debates. In that first parliament, the atmosphere was totally different from what we experience today in this parliament. Because we were writing the 1996 constitution, we had weekly discussions and debates, mostly in small groups, on how we see the future of South Africa. We were forced to listen to each other and had to try to understand the other person's viewpoints. In this, Mr. Kathrada was a good listener and debater looking for win-win solutions. What did I learn from those days? I learned that I do not mind that you criticize me for what I believe in, but do not criticize me for what you think I believe in. I learned from that from those discussions with Mr. Kathrada and his viewpoints. I miss this in our present parliament, where we debate each other without really trying to understand what exactly the other side said or believes in. Ek wil dit tog in Afrikaans herhaal. Ek gee nie om dat jy my kritiseer vir dit waaraan ek glo nie, maar ek is uiters gefrustreerd as jy my kritiseer vir dit wat ek dink, wat jy dink ek glo en wat ek nie glo nie. Sonder dat jy ooit moeite gedoen het om werklik my standpunt te leer ken of my te probeer verstaan. With this attitude of Mr. Kathrada, he invited me in 2012 to make a speech at the annual Ahmed Kathrada Foundation conference. And the title was, What Does Unity and Diversity Mean for Me as an Afrikaner? And you can go and read my speech if you want. Mr. Kathrada's strongest qualities were friendliness and humility. But one should not for one minute doubt his iron resolve to achieve his goals. When we are young, we all have dreams as to how we will change the world and how we shall put our stamp on it. It is given to few persons to live out their dreams in their lifetime. Mr. Kathrada succeeded in doing this. Against big odds, he had realized the vision he had as a young man. Sir, a leader who acts merely to be popular isn't a real leader. A real leader must be prepared to go against the majority because he or she knows that they are wrong and he or she must provide leadership to them in doing so. That is not always easy. Mr. Kathrada was such a leader up to the end, where he criticized leaders that he differed from. No one can deny the impact that Mr. Kathrada had made on South Africa. The reaction following his death confirms this. Speaker, on behalf of the Freedom Fund Plus, I wish to express my sympathy with Mr. Kathrada's family and also with Barbara Hogan, that I also learned to know better in those beginning years. I thank you.